Why? Because we are judging from outside. Now we go to him, say, oh, crazy, mental disturbed person. What are you doing? He said, no, I'm a doctor. He has deadly disease in his forearm. So I'm cutting it off to save his life. Is he good or bad now?
He's good.
Because you judge him, what about God's actions, which is way above us? Clear? I know it's clear.
Answer.
Alhamdulillah. You see? So, alhamdulillah. You
and
see?
That question was actually given to, I'm not sure if you've seen it on YouTube, it was given to Dr. Zakir Naik. You've heard of him?
About me, Zakir Naik, yes, he called to Christianity, but I don't say he's innovator, or, but he made some stuff which is very...
But he's a knowledgeable man.
He's a knowledgeable when it comes to memorizing the Bible and everything, yeah.
Bible, not the Quran.
Yeah, even more as the Quran, yeah. But that's not enough because, for example, let me make it to you. When he always ask, I don't know if you took it back, but when he always ask, can Allah do everything, okay? So the man, I don't know if he said yes. He said yes, then the guy said, okay, can Allah create someone tall and a short at the same time? Then Zakir Naik, he said, I can name 1,000 things which Allah cannot do. We should not be speaking about Allah. Huh? Cannot do, yeah? Firstly, clearly he doesn't know study Aqidah correctly. Because what the guy asked doesn't exist in the real life. It's not a thing. Because why this comes from the superstar Ion, which is the Greeks, philosophers, that existed before Aristotle and Plato. Aristotle himself and Plato refute them. This group of superstar Ion, they used to make fallacy arguments just to cause confusion. First of all, let us define what is a thing to begin with. Okay, and contradicting thing doesn't exist in the real life to begin with, and Allah is able to do all things. So if you say tall, you're already negating to be short.
Yeah.
You see, so just playing with words. You see, for example, can Allah created God, another God? That is another fallacy. Why? Because by definition, God is uncreated. If Allah created another God, that cannot be God. It's created. You see. So, and this go back when we studied the Aqidah of the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. But to bring you back here, you know, we earlier on here when I was speaking to the guy, the example I mentioned, look, the example I mentioned, bro, you know that you are here. Look, if you're in a house here and there is a fire, you've been surrounded with a fire, okay? Surrounded with fire, you're about to die. You gave up. And I came and I saved your life. What would you say to me at least?
Thank you.
Would you remember me all the time?
Yeah.
For your life, okay? So why we are not grateful and thankful for the one who gave us a life for free? You see, and I always mention another example about 2 million. I don't know if you heard it.
Aye.
The eyes, yes. You see, that's what Allah said in the Quran. If you count Allah's blessings, you'll never be able to do so. Second one, how? According to His will. That's what Islam look is just. We say, yes, if I was alive at the time of Jesus, the only way to worship God is by following Jesus' teaching. Before Jesus, Moses. Now is the last prophet is Muhammad. Wallah, bro, the prophecies that Prophet Muhammad said and the miracles of Islam and how Allah aided Islam is unbelievable. You know, the woman earlier on asked me, she said, I'm from Europe. Why there is a lot of doubt and misconceptions against Islam? I said, I will give you answer, not from me, from a Christian Orientalist. A Christian Orientalist said, the reason there is a huge war against Islam, he's a Christian, but he was honest. He said, because Islam is an obstacle against the Western ideology, which is a liberal ideology, okay? For example, in the Western world, it's okay to use a woman to sell a car. It's allowed to put a naked woman next to it is a car, okay? And Islam says, no, woman is a respectful human being.
Yeah.
You cannot use that as a tool. They don't like that, okay? And Islam teaches you, look, Islam came to preserve lineage. Why? Because the lineage, you want to know who's your brother, who's your sister, who's your mother, who's your uncle, because they have a right over you. But fornication will cut off that. Because likewise, heritage, they have to, you have to share the heritage, okay? Islam cut off that, adultery. Likewise, Islam and liberal teach you fornicate, halal, bismillah. You know, of course, I would be learning that. But that's what they said. I mean, everything is okay. Likewise, interest, Islam is against interest. And Western world is based upon that. You see? But yet, Islam is spreading. You know, one of the biggest doubts against Islam, that Islam oppresses women. And majority of people that accept Islam in the Western world is women. Bro, who is doing the job? It's the Most High, bro. You know you want to worship God. So why is it taking you a long time? You never know you're going to die, bro. You understand? You know, maybe today you will leave, you never come back. Bro, people are getting stabbed for nothing. You understand? You're not over. you know Allah sent the Quran. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ ذُكِّرَ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِ ثُمَّ أَعْرَضَ عَنْهَا إِنَّا مِنَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُنْتَعِمُونَ. Who is more unjust than the one who has been reminded with Allah's verses, Allah's signs, and he turns away from it? Then we'll take our revenge. You know, bro, the proofs for God's existence, for Allah Jalla wa Ala, is countless, okay? There is a universal proofs and there is legislative proofs. For a man to turn away from it and reject God, then blame God for being in the hellfire, then it's a foolish. You know? Why? Because God will give you intellect, make it clear to you, stay away from this path of the devil. And the devil said he wants to take mankind to the hellfire. Why are you taking it as an advisor? And this is a testimony of Islam. You know when people accept Islam, what does it mean? You have it inside you that yes, I should testify. There's no one worthy of worship except Allah, and testify Muhammad, the messenger of Allah. Meaning, O God, O my creator, I should worship you according to your will.
Ak, and hopefully one last question, hopefully. Just to clarify, because...
So after that you say shahada, inshallah.
Today is not the day.
When?
Today is not the day,
Ak. How do you know? Tomorrow you're going to live?
I don't know that, but...
I already know the hellfire.
God forbid if I was to die today, God forbid, and I may be wrong.
That's what I'm saying, why?
I think with my intentions and everything that Allah knows, because Allah
of course, no hesitation.
I don't want to say I'm good.
No, but no, define what is good. Many people, they say, I'm good to the people. That's something good. But if I'm good to the people and I abandon my parents, am I good? No, because why? I'm missing priorities. Likewise, you're good people, but who should be
no,
creator,
but with the
bro?
Priority of God being first.
Yeah, why you don't accept his testimony? Because why do you accept his prophet?
Before I accept the testimony.
Okay, go on, ask question. You don't know. Go on.
Are you sure Ak is raided?
And mercy of God, man. Okay. Come on, man. We come from questions. Albania, man.
Yes, man. questions, bro.
Let's go, bro. Let's go. Alhamdulillah, the rahma, anyway. Yeah, Allah. Well, Allah guided to Islam. Take shahada today.
Hopefully.
Go on.
Ak, I'm going to be honest with you.
Yeah. Where's the question?
It's the time for you now.
Man. The questions that I have are...
Oh, you wanna... You can take my number, brother.
Please.
Yeah, take my number, please. Where are you from?
I'm from Acton.
Acton? Bro.